الحمد لله رب العالمين، نحمده ونستعين به ونستهديه ونستغفره، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وحبيبه. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وصحبه ومن اهتدى بهديه واستنى بسنته إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، my dear brothers and sisters, I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless you and to accept our deeds and forgive our sins. Ameen, ameen, ya Rabbil Alameen. I would like to share with you inshallah in these few minutes. Are you ready to receive the month of Ramadan? Do you remember that today is the 10th of Sha'ban? We have just a couple of weeks away from the month of Ramadan. And the sunnah of our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam and our righteous predecessors that used to be get ready for the month of Ramadan, used to be ready for the month and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help them to reach the month of Ramadan, saying, Allahumma ballighna Ramadan. Allahumma barik lana fi Rajab wa Sha'ban wa ballighna Ramadan. Now, in the light of this critical situation that we can say and realize the importance of this kind of dua, Allahumma ballighna Ramadan. Oh Allah, help us to reach the month of Ramadan, ya Rabbal Alameen. My dear brothers and sisters, I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from those who will attend this month of Ramadan bi'idhnillahi ta'ala and all Ramadans. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala open the gates of Jannah for us. Like our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned, if Ramadan comes, the gates of Jannah will be opened and the gates of hellfire will be closed. And the shayateen, the satans, will be chained. And the caller will call for people, O seeker of goodness, come forward and do good deeds. And the caller will call, O seeker of evils, stop and go back. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive people and free people, the necks of people from hellfire, and this every night. Are you ready to receive the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the forgiveness that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned in the hadith for the people who fast, who stand for qiyam, who spend the night of qadr in worship, that they will have their previous sins forgiven? من قام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. من صام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. من قام ليلة القدر إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. So this is this forgiveness that we are looking for, inshallah. So get ready for the month of Ramadan bi'idhnillahi ta'ala. How to prepare yourself? Like our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and our righteous predecessors used to get ready before the month of Ramadan, 6 months, to take the advantage and to make the most, you know, benefits of this month, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam. What should we do to prepare ourselves for the month of Ramadan? Number one, intention and niyyah. Intention is really significant in our religion, because we're going to be rewarded according to our intention. The Prophet said, وَعَلَى نِيَّاتِكُمْ تُرْزَقُونَ, as our Prophet Muhammad said in another narration, according to our intention, we're going to be provided from the spiritual provision and for physical provision. So intention is really important. Why intention is really important? Because if you have intention to fast the month of Ramadan, if you have intention to do good deeds in the month of Ramadan, if you have intention to give a charity in the month of Ramadan, and for any reason Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has decreed for us not to attend the month of Ramadan, we're going to be rewarded. We're going to receive our reward, inshallah ta'ala. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith, if you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to die as a shaheed, sincerely, Allah will help you to reach the status of the martyrs, even if you do not die in the battlefields. If you died in your bed, you will reach the status of the shaheed because of your intention. So intention is really important to have and to resolve with Allah Ta'ala. What should we do too? Repentance. Turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in repentance. Free yourself from any kind of sins or any kind of injustices in these days, especially in the month of Sha'ban, when our deeds will be raised to Allah according to the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. when he was asked from the Sahaba, Ya Rasulullah, we are seeing you fasting so much in the month of Sha'ban, voluntarily fasting in the month of Sha'ban, and more than any kind of month. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith, ذاك شهر ترفع فيه الأعمال إلى الله وأحب أن يرفع عملي وأنا صائم. He said in the hadith, this is the month when the deeds will be raised to Allah, and I would like my deeds to be raised to Allah while I'm fasting. So make sure in the month of Sha'ban to get ready, to get in mood, to ignite the spirit of, you know, working for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Pay attention, wake up. Wake up, wake your family, your children. Don't worry about the coronavirus. We're gonna spend the month of Ramadan in ibadah, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. Some of the scholars, they're talking about fasting. It is permissible to break your fast because the coronavirus will be dangerous. Fasting is one of the acts of worship in the month of Ramadan. But the month of Ramadan has a lot of things to do, my dear brothers and sisters. It has the Quran, it has the charity, it has so many good deeds that we can think about it. And it will be rewarded, inshallah. Of course, fasting is the highest and the highly rewarded act of worship in the month of Ramadan. But if it has excuse not to fast in this month, it's not gonna stop us to, you know, do other good deeds بإذن الله تعالى. شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honors the month of Ramadan, not only because of the fasting, but because the Quran itself. Get closer to the Quran. Get closer to Quran to increase your faith, to give you steadfastness at this critical time. الَّذِينَ إِذَا إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ إِذَا ذُكِرَ اللَّهُ وَجِلَ قُلُوبُهُمْ. The true believers, those who when they remember the mention the name of Allah, their hearts are gonna be in the state of wajal or khushu' to Allah, humbleness to Allah. وَإِذَا تُلِيَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتُهُ زَادَتْهُمْ إِيمَانًا. When you recite the verses of the Quran, you know, it will increase your faith, your peace, your tranquility, your reliance on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the impact of the Quran in our life. This is what makes a believer unique and different and distinguished from any kind of people who commit suicide or, you know, kill themselves. But believers are different, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam. Get closer to Quran, read the Quran, remember Allah, mention the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the time to strengthen our faith and show Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the goodness from ourselves. So repentance, be ready, prepare yourself for the month of Ramadan, and make sure that don't get affected or impacted or confused by, you know, the news and consumed by this kind of critical situations. You know, make sure that you stay in faith and your words become your reality all the time. Always have the glad tiding. Always see what is nice, what is beneficial, what, you know, bring the tranquility for yourself and for your family and for the people around you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bless us. Allah will protect us. This is the protection of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the glad tiding that Allah has given to those who are patient at the time of difficulty. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make it easy for us. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless you and to accept our deeds and to help us to reach the month of Ramadan. بإذن الله تعالى أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. توبوا إلى الله واستغفروه. الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل. سبحانك ربنا لا نحصي ثناء عليك أنت كما أثنيت على نفسك. أما بعد، my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, repentance, have a good intention, prepare for the month of Ramadan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala criticize the people who don't pay attention for the, you know, the season of goodness, like the month of Ramadan and other seasons that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has opened for the believer. وَلَوْ أَرَادُوا الْخُرُوجِ لَأَعَدُّوا لَهُ عُدَّةٌ وَلَكِنْ كَرِهَ اللَّهُمْ بِعَاثَهُمْ فَثَبَّطَهُمْ وَقِيلَ قُعُدُوا مَعَ الْقَاعِدِينَ. If they really want to spend, you know, time to maximize the month of Ramadan, they may, you know, prepare for this and make this kind of preparation. Remember that we have halaqa tonight, inshallah, after Salat al-Maghrib. We're going to talk a lot about this kind of stuff, how to prepare ourselves, how to place the tranquility and the love and reliance on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, tawakkul and glorification, how to bring the peace and tranquility in our life at the time of fear, at the time of disturbance, at the time when people losing their faith and losing their life. this is حلقة after صلاة المغرب بإذن الله تعالى at 7:30. بارك الله فيكم, تقبل الله منا ومنكم صالح الأعمال. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. وصل اللهم وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. اللهم احفظنا بحفظك واكنفنا بكنفك واحرسنا بعينك. اللهم ابعد عنا الأمراض والأسقام والأوبئة يا رب العالمين. اللهم إنا نسألك علما نافعا ورزقا واسعا وعملا متقبلا وشفاء من كل داء. اللهم انصرنا واحفظنا واهدنا وارزقنا وتوب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. اللهم لا يأتي بالحسنات إلا أنت, ولا يذهب السيئات إلا أنت, ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بك. اللهم إنا نسألك اليمن والبركة ونعوذ بك من الشؤم والهلكة. اللهم إنا نسألك اليمن والبركة ونعوذ بك من الشؤم والهلكة. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه, وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. اللهم إنك إذا هديتنا للإسلام فلا تنزعه منا ولا تنزعنا منه حتى تقبضنا ونحن عليه, واحفظنا بالإسلام قائمين, واحفظنا بالإسلام راقدين, واحفظنا بالإسلام قاعدين غير فاتنين ولا مفتونين ولا ضالين ولا مضلين. ولا تشمت بنا عدوا ولا حاسدا يا رب العالمين, إنك على ما تشاء قدير وإنك نعم المولى ونعم النصير. اللهم بارك لنا في رجب وشعبان وبلغنا رمضان, وصل اللهم وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه. جزاكم الله خيرا, والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. صلاة الظهر, صلاة الظهر 4 ركعات بإذن الله تعالى. Remember that you pray your own prayer with yourself. صلاة الظهر instead of صلاة الجمعة 4 ركعات بإذن الله تعالى. بارك الله فيكم, تقبل الله منا ومنكم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.